Welcome. We are a fine group of Temple Occupational Therapy students, and we're going to tell you about our group we ran called ExStressYourself. The purpose of this group is that through artistic and verbal expression, graduate students will be able to address internal and external stressors, perceptions, and barriers regarding their journey through the program.
Now we will give you a description of our activity. The subjects that we used are first-year graduate students that might be experiencing some stress. Our inclusion criteria was they had to be enrolled in a graduate program, a score above a 12 for men and a 13 for women on the perceived stress scale, and a score above a level 5 on the Allen cognitive levels. Our exclusion criteria was that if they were physically unable to participate with appropriate modifications.
The time frame for this group would be 1 hour with a group size of 7 to 8 people. The frame of reference used for this group was the coping frame, which focuses on the adaptive process and how to manage internal and external stressors. The instruments used were the perceived stress scale, the numerical stress scale, and the Allen cognitive levels.
To run this group, you can start off with first introducing all of the group leaders. Next, you will want to get your group to come together and get involved and interested in the activity that you are about to present. You can do this by asking stimulating questions, such as how many of you have felt stress this past semester, or even just this week. If you have enough time and want a further input, then you can ask, how do some of you deal with stress? Next, you can start the group with a description of what will be happening, as well as the purpose of the group, which was discussed earlier. Now, the leaders can have the group members self-report stress levels through a 1 to 10 rating scale. After completing the stress scale, the leaders can give the supplies to the group. To continue, after the supplies are distributed, the group members will draw pictures, symbols, and write words inside and outside of the self-drawn silhouette. Drawing inside the silhouette will represent internal stressors, while drawing outside the silhouette will represent external stressors or barriers. Internal stressors can be anything that is going on inside a person's mind or body that affects them. For example, emotional thoughts or feelings are considered internal. External stressors are more like money or a physical environment that we are in. Once the group understands the different stressors and completes their drawings, they will be asked to sit around a table and share what they drew. When the group is sharing, the members will be prompted by the leader to look for similarities, differences, coping methods, and anything else that may come to mind. Lastly, there will be a debriefing session that includes processing questions and the benefits of the activity.
The supplies and equipment required for this activity are simple. There's markers, crayons, colored pencils, pens, and paper, whether you use construction or computer paper. So the cost would only be about $10 to $15 to run the group.
And that will show you a few images that were drawn in a real type example, and we'll have the authors of these images explain one or two things about why they chose the things they chose.
This picture shows some outside stressors such as school and moving to a new city, and also inside stressors of an unknown future and questions about what's going to happen.
Some of the external stressors in this picture: the sun in the corner represents missing Florida, there's a house for taking care of, an apartment, textbooks for school, and family and friends, and money. Internal stressors are getting good grades, always having a to-do list in my mind, and just the X's represent missing out on things, and then security, success, perfectionism, and procrastination.
This last example has pictures for external stressors, as living with a large family can be stressful, money issues, and a serving tray for my job, which will be an external stressor, as well as a sun, even though I'm not from Florida. I don't like when it's not sunny. And then some internal stressors are trying to stay healthy while dealing with school and the lack of sleep because of finals. And not being able to see my boyfriend is the heart, and then time management is the clock. After the activity is completed, the leaders can discuss a group discussion using some processing questions. Some of these questions are, how did you feel using art to express stressors and what emotions were felt. Next, the leader can ask the group if they felt comfortable with the activity and if they learned anything about themselves.
Some questions for generalizing to see how the group was run are, how are some the stressors similar and or different among group members? Does it help to hear other people's stressors? Was there one stressor that everybody felt strongly about? Do your internal and external stressors align with each other? And do you feel that the activity helped facilitate stress relief? Application questions are used to see how the things that were done in the group can be applied in everyday life outside of the group. So one question is, how can this activity give you ideas on how to handle stress? Would you use this activity again? Now that you are aware of shared stressors, how will you utilize your peers and the environment in coping with stress? Why do you think it is beneficial to talk to your peers, especially in stressful situations? And do you think people bond when placed in stressful situations? And how can this apply to your future?
The goals of this fine exercise are to provide an outlet for stress reduction through self-expression and discussion, to uncover commonalities among stressors within the group, and to create a safe place where peers can share their concerns and acquire new coping techniques.
In summary, this group emphasizes that speaking to others in similar stressful situations has the ability to decrease stress. It also assists in group bonding and can help people find new ways to cope with common stresses of the program. Example, study tips, organization, and time management. And it can also create an environment in which peers feel safe to share their common concerns. Thank you for listening.